This video explains the amount of insulin your child needs with each injection. There are two types of insulin, long-acting insulin and fast-acting insulin. Both types of insulin come in a glass bottle called a vial. Both types are injected using a syringe. Insulin is measured in units, and you will see the unit numbers on the specific syringe that matches your insulin. This helps you draw up the right amount of insulin each time. You will give your child the same amount of long-acting insulin every day at the same time. So, for example, you might give 10 units every day at 7 p.m. But fast-acting insulin is different. The amount of fast-acting insulin may be different each time it is given. So, for example, you might give 4 units with breakfast, 6 units at lunch, and 5 units at dinner. This is because the fast-acting insulin does two different jobs: covering carbs and correcting high blood sugars. Most people eat different amounts of carbohydrates at each meal. The blood sugar level will also be different each time it is checked. You will use some basic math to tell you how much fast-acting insulin to give each time. Here is the insulin math worksheet. I'm going to show you how to fill it out. Don't worry if this doesn't make sense right away. You can practice as much as you need with the diabetes team. At the top, you should write your child's insulin sensitivity factor and your child's carb ratio. Your doctor will tell you what these numbers are for your child. The insulin sensitivity factor, or ISF, tells us how sensitive a person is to insulin. For example, an insulin sensitivity factor of 50 means that one unit of fast-acting insulin will lower blood sugar by about 50 points. So just for this example, let's write 50 here. Your child may have a different ISF. The carb ratio tells us how many grams of carbohydrates that one unit of fast-acting insulin can cover. So, as an example, if your carb ratio is 1 to 10, that means one unit of fast-acting insulin covers 10 grams of carbohydrates. In our example, we are going to write 10 here. Again, your child's carb ratio may be different. Now on to part 1, correcting high blood sugars. You will test your child's blood sugar and write that number here. For this example, let's pretend the reading was 300. On the next line, you write your child's top of target range number. For this example, let's say the target range is between 90 and 150. So the top of target range number is 150. Now, subtract the top of target range from the current blood sugar and write the answer here. We are going to divide this number by the insulin sensitivity factor. For our example, this is 50. So now we know that we need 3 units of fast-acting insulin to correct for high blood sugar. 3 units of fast-acting insulin should bring the blood sugar down from 300 to the top of target range, which is 150. On to part 2, covering carbs. Carbohydrate counting is a skill explained in the video called Carbohydrates. For this example, let's just say you check the nutrition label and it says there are 30 grams of carbohydrates per serving. And your child is having 2 servings. So your child will be eating 60 grams of carbohydrates. Write 60 grams of carbs. On the next line, write the carb ratio. Remember, in our example, this is 10. One thing to know is that your child's carb ratio number may change as they get older. Then, we will divide the total carbs by the carb ratio. Here, that means we need 6 units of fast-acting insulin to cover the carbs in our example meal. Now, we are at part 3. Add both insulin amounts together. Write the units of insulin to correct high blood sugar, and write the units for covering carbs. Add these two together, and we get the total amount of fast-acting insulin for the injection. Part 4 is for rounding to the nearest half or whole unit. You will be drawing up insulin using either half or whole units, so you might need to round up or round down in step 4. You will be able to practice this math with your diabetes team. They will work with you until you are comfortable calculating insulin on your own.